Where can you find strong New York Central heritage, consistently scheduled trains, stunning scenery, and a railfan-friendly environment? Nowhere but Western New York's Finger Lakes Railway. In December 2022, I visited the railway to document its historic locomotives and diverse operations. From Solvay to Geneva and everywhere in between, I present to you a legacy of lightning, the Finger Lakes Railway. It's mid-December and I'm in Solvay, New York, on the hunt for the Finger Lakes Railway. There's a semaphore signal that I want to shoot GS2 at. That's really cool. And actually they have a decent amount of snow here. I guess it didn't rain like it did in Utica. The first Finger Lakes train we catch is the local switcher, SH2. Based out of the railway's yard in Solvay, SH2 runs to the West Rock paperboard facility in Fairmount several times a week. Normally SH2 uses a leased MP15 switcher, but on this day, ex-Southern Railway B23-7, number 2304, is powering the job. Looks like another switching move. The old 2304. Good. Yeah, this is a quiet zone, but horns as needed. And in this case, I'd say it was needed. Let's get on the chase. SH1 heading back to Solvay Yard. Beautiful. B23 leading the charge, long hood forward. Remote control unit too. That crew man you saw standing on the end of the platform is the only person on this job. Our next shot of SH2 was near Boxcar Lane, where I met up with my friend Jason. You know what time it is, folks? It's chase time. Let's go. Do not stop on tracks.
Bet you never saw a crossing with a bell and no flashers or crossbucks. There they go into Solvay Yard. We'll return in a bit for some more Finger Lakes Railway action.
After grabbing some Arby's and catching a few trains at nearby CP293, we head back towards Fairmount to look for our next Finger Lakes Railway train, Road Freight GS2.
We're gonna get turned around and chase them back towards Solvay Yard.
GS2 departs from the railroad's headquarters in Geneva for the CSX interchange in Solvay 6 days a week. This Friday edition of GS2 was quite heavy, resulting in a trio of GP38-2s powering the train. GS2 arriving in Solvay Yard. Now the train has the red light and the cars have the green light. That's a pretty neat system. It's literally a four-way intersection, but with a railroad and a road. While we wait for GS2 to do whatever in the yard, we can take a look at this system some more. So you have the lights here that are somehow connected to a detection circuit with, I can't really see it under the snow, but it's there. You have a crosswalk signal here for the sidewalk here. And then you have the road crossings, and they're all wired together to ensure no one runs into each other. Here we go, westbound Chase. And there's Jason for the last time today. Once again, huge shout out, check out his channel. We're gonna chase now. And it looks like we probably missed our shot at the semaphore. Yeah, it looks like we missed it, oh well. I don't know if I'll be able to jump out in time.
the Home Depot Plaza, whatever it's called, here in Fairmount. Fairmont? I don't know.
Our final shot of the day was at Martisco, where I found a beautifully restored depot museum.
Watch this hill they're climbing. It doesn't look as good on camera, but
it's quite the profile they have here. Goodbye, East Rochester. Well, technically we're still here, but we're heading to Geneva, New York today, headquarters of the Finger Lakes Railway. We're gonna try to catch GS2, chase them eastbound, maybe meet up with a couple friends, fellow rail fans. And so we'll see what we get. Stay tuned.
Sunday morning at the Finger Lakes shops in Geneva finds a good portion of the roster resting for the weekend, including Jeeps, GEs, and the MP15. Adam, whose video is linked above, showed up in time to watch GS2 back onto their train.
Thank you.
GS2 departing Geneva. It's chase time, let's go. That is some old rail right there, folks. W cars. Rolling through Waterloo, Cayuga. Right on the tip of Cayuga Lake. Finger Lakes Railway Causeway. It's right there. GS2 will be going over it any minute. And continuing eastward towards Auburn. That's a nice little spot. Heading into Auburn, I think we're gonna see what's going on there and then probably break it off for the day because we got a long drive home.
GS2 heads to work the glass facility east of town as we briefly check out another B23-7 in Auburn Yard before heading towards home. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to subscribe because we have plenty more videos like this on North Country Trains.